I always thought I was a little weird. I kept to myself more than the people around me do. I'd much rather read a nice book than go out partying. I dislike small talk, and I hate how nervous I get when I have to participate in it. Turns out, I'm not that weird. Just a full-fledged introvert. Now, when I say introvert, you'd most likely start imagining a quiet person, unwilling to participate in conversation, someone who would much rather listen than talk. The question Susan Cain asks is that really such a bad thing? Introverts make up about one-third to half of the population. But of course, everyone prefers it if you're extroverted. I remember when I was a kid, my teachers always complained to my parents, "Your son is so introverted, he needs to come out of his shell." The word introvert seems to be used as if it was a mark of shame. Here's the thing though, there's nothing like a correlation between being the best talker and having the best ideas. Some of the greatest thinkers and artists of the world have also been introverts. People who quietly changed the world, from Vincent van Gogh to Albert Einstein to Steve Wozniak. Without introverts, the world would have been devoid of the theory of gravity, the theory of relativity, Google, Harry Potter, and who knows what else. It's become a cultural norm that the ideal person is extroverted, outgoing, well-spoken, confident. Extroverted people are thought of as being more important, more authoritative, and more attractive. If you're shy, you're considered as a pushover, a bad leader, timid. To be successful, you need to stand up for yourself, push people out of the way, be the loudest and take risks. Isn't that what's taught to us? And you know what? That is, in fact, true. Extroverts obviously get their voices heard, but does the fact that extroverts are good leaders necessarily mean that introverts are bad leaders? When faced with a crisis, say their company is facing a lawsuit, an extrovert will immediately rally the troops, inspire confidence in his employees, and assure them it'll be alright. On the other hand, an introvert would probably take some time to think about the problem, consult with his lawyers, and then quietly send an email to everyone informing them that the problem has been taken care of. Both of these are examples of good leadership. The only difference is an extrovert would react first, while the introvert would inspect first. As for the apparent stereotype that introverts lack courage, Rosa Parks, the woman who changed the face of American history by standing up against racism, was rather a quiet person herself. What I want to say is that being quiet and having fortitude are not mutually exclusive terms, but rather two qualities that are independent of each other. I do not mean to degrade any of the two groups. My only point is that strength does not have to be loud, in your face, or aggressive. Strength and conviction can present themselves quietly without sacrificing effectiveness. Quiet is a remarkable book. It gives insights into the thinking of both introverts and extroverts. It does not place any personality type over the other, but teaches how to leverage your personality effectively in leadership, marketing, and personal life.